Hello guys, welcome to Geeks for Geeks. In this video we will learn how to delete a linked list. Before getting into the problem, let's understand why we need to delete a linked list but not an array. As we know, memory is allocated during compile time in case of array, but in the case of linked list, memory allocation is done dynamically during runtime. So some programming languages require us to delete the memory assigned to the linked list. Let's understand what the problem is. We are given a linked list and we have to delete the entire list. By deletion, it means we have to free the memory allocated to each node. For example, if we are given a linked list such as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have to deallocate the memory allocated to each of the nodes, storing the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then make the head point to null. Let's understand the algorithm for solving this problem. In step 1, we declare a pointer current and initialize it to point to the head node. In step 2, we check whether current is pointing to null, that is whether the list is empty. If it isn't, then we declare pointer next and point it to the next node of current so as to keep track of the next node. This is step 2a. We need this because if we simply delete the current node, our link with the following nodes will be lost and then we will not be able to free the memory allocated to them. Next, we move to step 2b. We free the memory allocated to the current node. And then in step 2c, we update the current pointer to point to the next node. In step 3, we proceed with the deletion by repeating step 2 until the current pointer points to null, that is end of the list. Finally, in step 4, we set the head pointer to null to signify the deletion of the linked list. Now let's understand the implementation of algorithm in C programming language. Here, the delete list function is used to delete the given list where the head node of the source list is passed as parameter. Now for deleting the nodes, we need to track the current node to delete the node and then move to next node for further deletion. Now for this to happen, we will consider a current node pointing to head node for tracking the current node and then the condition will be checked. If current is not null, that means the list is not empty and the loop will be executed. Now before deleting the current node, we need to set the next of current with another pointer so that the address of next nodes don't get lost. So we set next as next of current and then delete the current node, and after deletion move the current node to next node, and then the loop will keep iterating till the current node reaches null. Finally, when the current reaches null, the loop will not execute anymore and head will point to null. That means the list is empty now. Now let us see the working of delete list function with the help of an example. Here the input list to be deleted is taken as 1, 2, 3 and the head of the list, which is pointing to 1, will be passed to the delete function. Now we need to take a new pointer, say current, which will point to head, and another pointer next, which will be used to keep track of next nodes. Now the while condition will be checked, and since the current is pointing to 1, which is not null, the loop will be executed and next pointer will point to next of current now, that is 2. As we can see, After setting the next pointer, we have track of next node, so we can delete the current node from the memory. Now to continue deleting the other nodes, we will set the current pointer to point to the next node. Now back to while condition again. As we can see, current is not null. We will set next to next of current pointer for keeping the track of next node. And now again we can delete the current node and set the current pointer to next node. Again the next pointer will point to next of current as current is not null and current node will be deleted. Now current node will point to null. And finally, as current is pointing to null, the loop will not get executed anymore and head pointer will be pointing to null. Now we can see all the nodes are deleted. Let's clear up the nodes and have a look at the final list. We can see our list is empty.